Hello guys, welcome back. This is Anshul Chauhan from easyweeks.com. And guys, today we are going to start a new training. Sorry for this pop-up. Today we are going to start a new training. It's about the APM or the mobile testing. So this is the first tutorial in the mobile testing training. So this is about the APM introduction. So guys, let's have a look about the high-level agenda for today's training. So the very first, we will look into the introduction of the mobile automation. Then we will move to the types of mobile apps. And then we move to the APM architecture. So guys, let's move to our first topic for today's training. It's about the mobile automation introduction. So mobile automation is all about mobile software testing, or you can say Android testing, or you can say iOS testing. So guys, as all of you are already aware, in these days mobile is on peak. You are getting a new mobile app, almost every day, and we have a lot of agile market in mobile automation, because I think every month at least 10 new phones are launching in India. Yeah, I think if you can see, then every month at least 10 new phones are launching in India with a different processor, with different screen size, with different RAM and ROM, and all configuration are all too different. And you can see the we are getting the most of the companies, most of the big companies are dedicatedly investing their money on the marketing on mobile. You can see Flipkart, Amazon, and any merchant like Hotstar, and you can say like Paytm. They are all focusing on the mobile. They are promoting their mobile product. They are promoting their mobile app. In fact, you are getting a good amount of discount on mobile apps. So why these companies are doing this? Because in future time, it's all about the mobile. Because in a mobile, almost you have a powerful PC in your hand. Because in current mobile, I think the current configuration mobile, if you are going to market and you want to sell, you want to purchase a mobile, then you will get a mobile with the 3GB or 4GB RAM, and I think in the same number of GB RAMs are available inside the PCs as well. So mobile, there is a lot of scope about the mobile automation in these days, and obviously in future. And I must say the future is all about the mobile automation. Almost we have done with the UI automation or the API automation, and this will be the continuous in the coming days. But the mobile automation is a new era, and there is a lot of scope in the mobile automation testing field. So we will look into the mobile automation. We will see how we can do the mobile automation, how we can automate the Android apps, how we can automate the iOS apps, and how we can automate the web apps as well. But very first, we are starting the APM with the Android testing. After we will when we will complete the Android testing, we will post the videos on the iOS testing as well. In the mobile itself, there are two kind of testing. The one is software testing and the another is hardware testing, because mobile hardware plays a good role in the processing or in other areas in mobile, because mobile is a small device. And you can see many times, like it's happened, I don't remember the Samsung model which was blasting. I think it was J7 or something else. So you can see when heat up in the Samsung, there was a problem when it heats up, it was blasting. And in recent days, there was some scenarios or there was some incidents while the famous company, I think it's MI, the Xiaomi, at the mobile phones of the Xiaomi, the popular mobile phone Note A, I think it was blasting too. So there are a lot of hardware testing is also applicable on the mobile. But for the app, we are in the software industry field, so we will learn about the software testing, software functional testing using the APM. So very first, as I discussed, we will learn about the Android testing, then we will come to the iOS testing. In a mobile automation, user test the functionality of the mobile app. Obviously, with the help of the APM, we will test the functionality. We will do the functional testing. We are not doing any kind of load testing or other things, because load testing is not the part of the mobile testing, because ultimately load is going on the server. So for the load testing, we have the other tools and we have the other mechanism. But here we are ready to learn about the functional testing on mobile app. So user needs to set up the mobile environment to perform the mobile testing. So guys, in the coming videos, we will see how we can set up the mobile environment inside your PC or on your machine, how we can install the APN, how we can install the Android stuff, and how we can install the related plugins and related stuff which will help in the automation. So we will see. We will see how we can set up the environment for the mobile testing. So guys, next is mobile application types. There are three types of the mobile application available in the market. Okay, the first one is native app. So guys, native app are the platform dependent apps. Okay, these apps are created for the use of platform like mobile, tablet. So if you are talk about the calculator which you have natively inside your phone, if you talk about the WhatsApp, if you talk about the Hotstar or the Flipkart, so guys, these are the platform dependent apps. You can't install, download and install the iOS app on an Android platform, and the vice versa is not so true, okay, you can't install the Android app on the iOS because the complete architecture is different. The iOS is a different platform and the Android is a different platform, so you can't do this. If you want to install Android app on your Windows, then you can't do. Okay, so native apps are the platform dependent apps. Okay, these apps are created for the use of platform like mobile and tablet. Obviously, if you have the Android tablet, then you can install the same app on your mobile and on your tablet as well, because the OS is same, the platform is same, just the screen size is different. Okay, the next come mobile web app. Okay, so mobile web app are the server side apps. Okay, to access the website on the mobile using browser. If you can see, most of the websites comes with the m dot, like if we talk about the Facebook, it comes with the m.facebook.com. okay, if we talk about the Foodpanda, it comes with the m.foodpanda.com. a lot of websites have their native mobile web app. If you open the same website on the browser and if you open the same website on your mobile browser like Chrome, UC browser or your native browser, whatever you have installed on your mobile, then you will see the complete UI is different. The UI what you're getting on the PC is different from the UI what you're getting on the mobile. So mobile web apps are the different. Okay, these are the server side applications and access through the browser. And the next one is hybrid app. Hybrid apps are the combination of native and web apps. Although there are a lot of kind of apps, I don't remember any example yet, but there are a lot of apps in which some kind of things open in a browser and the complete app execute on a platform. Like when you click on the forgot password, it may be possible it will render you on the browser. Inside any app, if you click on the forgot password, which is a hybrid app, that may be possible it will render on a web page. Okay, so these are the hybrid apps. So these are the three apps which we have available in the mobile industry or in the mobile types. Okay, now we will learn about the APM architecture. Okay, so guys, as we know, APM is an open source tool developed by the Sauce Labs. Yes, APM is developed by the same company which is running or developing the Selenium. Okay, Selenium is developed by the Sauce Labs, and APM is also developed by the Sauce Labs. Again, Selenium is an open source tool, so that APM is also an open source tool. Selenium is for complete UI automation, functional UI automation, and APM is for completely functional mobile automation. Guys, APM supports automation of native and hybrid apps. APM doesn't support the automation of web apps. For the web apps, again, you need to use the Selenium. Okay, because it is running inside the browser, so it has the same configuration and same architecture as the website has. Okay, so for the web apps, we need to use the Selenium, but for the native and hybrid apps, we'll use the combination. For the native apps, completely we need to use the APM, but for the hybrid apps, we need to use the combination of APM and Selenium. So guys, how APM does work? Okay, so are you getting the diagram? Okay, so here we have first box about the Selenium WebDriver, then something like JSON wire protocol is going to the APM, then something UI automator is going to the Android web mobile app. And you can see with the Selenium WebDriver, it's a single directional JSON wire protocol which is going to APM, but from the APM to Android mobile app, it's a two-way communication using the UI automator. So we will discuss it. So APM uses JSON wire protocol internally, okay, to interact with the iOS and Android native apps using the Selenium WebDriver. Actually, when you execute the APM inside your machine, actually the first call is going to the Selenium WebDriver. Then the call resolved by the Selenium and it rendered to the APM with the help of the JSON wire protocol. Okay, now APM comes into the picture and it will find out, okay, it's an Android app or an iOS app. For the Android, it used the UI automator to communicate with the Android device. Okay, if you are confusing with the term, then UI automator is a native Android native architecture, automation architecture, which will help to communicate with the device. Okay, so JSON wire protocol is used by the Selenium WebDriver to communicate with the APM. So this is the way how APM works. Ultimately, APM has built on the top layer of the Selenium. So call is resolved, first the call is going to the Selenium, then it is resolved by the Selenium. A JSON wire protocol message sent to the APM. Now the APM has the control and it will further communicate to the Android mobile or Android app. Okay, so APM is on built on the top layer of the WebDriver. Okay, so WebDriver communicates with the APM using the JSON wire protocol and commands fired by the Selenium WebDriver communicate with the APM via JSON protocol. So this is the way how guys APM works. Okay, APM will communicate with the Android using the UI automator, and UI automator is an Android's native UI automation framework which supports running JUnit test cases directly into the device from the command line. So UI automator is something which is directly patched with the Android. Okay, it is not patched with the with the Selenium or with the APM. APM communicate with the UI with the mobile app or the mobile device using the UI automator. Okay guys, so guys, I hope you have liked the video. So if you have any doubt, any question, then please ask your question, put your question inside the comment box and we will be happy to answer you. If you like the video, then please click on the like button and share the video so that other people also get the help. And one important thing guys, if you still not subscribed my channel, then please subscribe it for the more updates. In the future we will discuss we will going to post the tutorials on the framework designing as well, complete APM with the Android, complete APM with the iOS, and as well we are going to post the tutorials on the REST API as well, and REST API framework structure and how we can develop the REST API framework, and how we can perform the automation of the REST API calls. Later on we have the plan for the JMeter as well. So guys, thank you guys, have a good day.